Short and sweet, these labs rock. I've been on a quest to improve the production output of our phones. We can make better things while we're out on the go and away from our computers. Smartphone cameras have gotten really good. Accessories have improved, mounts and gimbals, portable lighting. Audio was the long neglected component of that equation, but now we're a lot richer for options. Comica has been building a solid reputation in this space. Lower cost, higher quality audio. The CVM WS60 combo moves the segment forward in one crucial area. The WS60 kit is well stocked for $240, making it the least expensive wireless package I've used yet, which includes two microphones. It's a bit simple in terms of connection. The only output is a 3.5mm jack, but it does have a separate jack for audio monitoring, and the receiver controls stereo and mono mixes and volume controls for each transmitter. The tripod mount unscrews and extends to become a phone clamp. It's all very well thought out, even though it is the largest version of this system I've used yet. Even one of my gripes is fairly well handled, where I don't love that the transmitters and receiver use three AAA batteries apiece. They can also be powered off of a battery pack with a USB-C cable. Competitors in this space are a bit techier and cooler, like building microphones directly into the transmitters or being able to use the receiver as a USB audio interface. Comica doesn't offer anything that fun, and I was ready to write it off until I saw one critical spec. The WS60 does not broadcast in the 2.4 gigahertz space. You get 12 channels to play with between 560 and 580 megahertz, and that's a really big deal. There's a lot less competition under 600 megahertz. Products that play in the 2.4 gig spectrum have been great for open areas, but have all struggled in busy spots where there's lots of Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The signal gets interrupted and sizzle, pop, there goes your audio. The Comica worked like a champ in Taipei, where I was shooting vlogs and footage for Newegg. So one of the things that makes my job a little bit easier when we're talking about this technology stuff and when we're covering a show floor is when there's sort of like a general theme for what's going to be really hot or what's going to be really popular.
Or even like showing off your RGB SSDs. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it was almost like a focus on minimalism. You'd have these big cases with a lot of clean lines that are very open. And then, yeah, just a tiny little ITX motherboard. I love that.
And not a custom, but Leon Lee had a new case on the show floor that was very much built around, it was a two-unit case.
Yeah.
So you could have like a performance version where if you really wanted to max it out. And then it was purposely built to have that open, airy kind of aesthetic to it.
Very modern.
Just taking a quick sit, and I found this super giant light wall. It might be some of the largest RGBs I've ever seen.
But if you go digging, if you go looking for it, there's a second media room with tons of snacks. Like, this thing is fully catered. They've got quiche, they've got gourmet brownies and chocolate rolls and these garlic bread slivers. Like, awesome, just awesome. I had no idea that this other room even existed. And so we're sort of mooching. we're gonna have a media center snack lunch for our last day at Computex.
This is the most reliable, inexpensive consumer grade system I've used, and exactly the kind of competition we want to see. Even here in the Gadget Lab, where I've got plenty of products broadcasting Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, this has given me pretty consistent signal. The rest is academic. The battery life is okay, about 4 hours on a fresh set of AAAs. The audio quality is very good. A low cut filter is handy. Again, I had that on the entire time I was on the show floor. And the range is very good, but I doubt I'd ever really try to drive it out to the rated maximum distance of 30 meters in a busy area with some obstacles. They are a bit low tech, but the frequency they connect over can't be overstated as an advantage. They definitely won't unseat pro gear, certainly not as durable, but this is a solid step up for mobile audio. Vlogging, mobile journalism, interviews, podcasting, this stuff is getting really good. I'll of course have some links down below where you can find more info on the Comica CVM WS60. It shouldn't come as any great surprise that I recorded all of the audio for this video on the Comica. It's like I'm tapping you directly on the eardrum.
I totally couldn't help myself there. As always, thanks so much for watching, sharing these videos, subscribing to this channel. More than just nerding out on a fun microphone, we want to see how far we can push our mobile production and make cooler stuff. If you'd like to help support the production of those conversations, there are links below, or you could consider joining the list of names scrolling by on your screen right now. A fun, growing community of like-minded techies and an amazing resource for me as we've been strategizing and planning out future content. I hope you'll check it out. Now, you know where you can find me around the rest of the internet at SomeGadgetGuy on the Twitters and the Facebooks and the Instagrams and the Twitches, and I will catch you all on the next review.